What we should realize is that covalent bonds are formed when atomic orbitals basically just overlap with their electrons. Now, for electrons to overlap, they have to be in the same type of orbital. So an s orbital has to overlap with an s orbital. A p orbital has to overlap with a p orbital. So if we take a look at this first example, here we have two hydrogens. They want to combine together to give us H2. Now, their electron configurations are 1s1. So they each have one electron in their first shell. Now, they can overlap together to form a bond because here, what's going to be forming the bond are their s orbitals. Each s orbital needs one more electron in order to get to 1s2 so that each hydrogen can be just like helium. Now, again, since they're both s, they can overlap. So that's what they do. And the electrons are in here. And in this way, they get to share the electron of the other hydrogen. And in that way, they have two electrons around them and they're satisfied. Now, if we take a look at two chlorines, they can also overlap their p orbitals because their electron configurations would be argon, or actually neon, 3s2, 3p5, neon, 3s2, 3p5. Remember, chlorines want to gain one more electron to become just like argon. Where can that one electron go? It's going to go to the p orbitals, because remember, p can hold up to 6 electrons. So there's an electron in here, and there's an electron in here. And they're going to overlap with one another so that they can share those electrons. So here we're going to say is where they form their bond. And we're going to say this is a direct overlapping of their atomic orbitals. We say that this is called a sigma bond. A sigma bond is the direct overlapping of atomic orbitals. They share electrons with each other in order to complete their octet to be just like the closest noble gas.